Hello, and good morning, I guess. Happy Monday. I'm glad to finally be doing this on a Monday again. I'm still kind of last minute everything. I need to plug in the iPad. The animals have just been crazy today. The bird is in here right now. I'm trying not to step on him. Just made a mess on the floor. Gonna be one of those days. But my goal today is basically just to try to use up more of that pumpkin I still have from last week. Hey Brake, how are you doing today? How's your Monday? If you hear weird clicking, it's just like a bird walking into the cupboards. I'm just gonna put on some light background music. Oops, what's the password? Oh god. Yeah. Let me see if I can. Hey, that's it. Oh, it's still open to the last thing I played, so that works. Make sure it's not too loud. Everything is everywhere today, so I gotta do a little bit of cleaning before I actually. Maybe I should get the stuff in the oven because they take like. I'm gonna make more of that pumpkin bread that I made last time. And it takes like an hour to bake, so I think I might get that in the oven. As much as I hate working in a mess, I think I can do it. I can survive it. That's just random stuff. I don't know. This was from my roommate's parents. I'm just gonna see what I can do. Sticky. The restaurant slowed down, so you're at home. Oh, you actually got the day off? That sounds like a nice, relaxing Monday. Well, that's great. It was crazy this past week. They launched the new menu, and the new girl's like still slow and still obviously learning the new menu. So it was hectic this week. Where's my other one? Probably in the dishwasher. Saturday. Friday and Saturday were crazy. Saturday I was supposed to only just go in and do inventory. But I ended up having to go on the line and help out because it was just so busy. So yeah, I mean, that's good. It's good to be busy. I'm sure my boss is happy. We've had a slow past few months, so that's good. I don't know where my other. Please don't say it's dirty. Where is it? Oh, it's in the sink. Okay. Thank you. It was, I guess, on my Amazon wish list, and I opened it. A couple days ago, I was like, oh, I can wear this on Monday. Works out perfectly. I do have another one that I don't think I've worn on a screen yet. Especially because afterwards, when I'm working with flour and stuff, it's like, oh, I wish I had an apron. And it's like, I do. Might as well wear it. It's really cute and it's like all frilly and old school. I like it. And it even has a pocket, which is nice. I might do the bread in this one then, since I only have one of these. Hopefully it bakes okay. It was really good, so I'm definitely gonna make more. Honestly, it tastes just like banana bread. See if I can find that recipe. Oops, sorry YouTube. I can't remember if I opened it on Chrome or Safari. I think Safari. I've been looking at Airbnbs to see if I could maybe rent something for a few days since it's hard to get a good camping spot right now. So I thought it might be fun to do an Airbnb and like just get away and take pictures and stuff and maybe stream from a different location. I thought that would be fun. But everything's really expensive. I didn't expect things to be like $300 a night. What am I looking for? not banana, pumpkin bread. Okay. So yeah, which one did I use is the question. I think it was this one. No, not jump to video. No, not print the rest. No, that works. It's actually easier. Okay, I think this was the recipe. So I need flour. Hey! Your name's familiar. Mike, how are you? How's your Monday going? I'm just gonna try to find a bowl. So many dishes are dirty right now. I'm gonna have a lot of dishes to do today. Dishwasher's full of clean dishes, at least. So I gotta put those away. Even though I did. Didn't I run the dishwasher when I was streaming last time? Or was it the next day? I don't know. I ran it like a week ago and it still hasn't been empty. So at least it feels like a week ago. I don't know if it was. So yeah. I haven't cooked anything else in this kitchen, but it is a disaster over there. I am doing pretty well. I am finally back to normal scheduling at work. Or should be. Hopefully it doesn't change, but everyone said they're okay if I'm back to the schedule that I want. So I'm happy. I have today and tomorrow off, and then I'm hoping I actually haven't checked my phone, but my mom, I was supposed to go for a walk with my mom today after this. Let me just double check. I think that's the cats downstairs. But yeah, I'm doing well. I was sick. I'm doing better. Weather's still not great, but it's not raining anymore. Rained all weekend again. And I think it's supposed to warm up this week, so I'm excited. Actually might be able to clean up my backyard a little bit. Okay, what am I doing? Flour. Okay. Hopefully... Gosh, try not to step on this bird. It's just like poking around. Being weird. No, that's an air vent. Don't go down. Ziggy, come on, no. I'm trying to squeeze under the covers into the... There's a vent there, but it doesn't have a cover on it. Ziggy, come here. 1 second. Ziggy, come on. Where do you want to sit? Sit over here without destroying anything? Getting in the way? You want to sit on here? Alright. Cooking with a bird. Somebody's. It's like cooking with a 2-year-old. Well, I don't actually know. I'm sure it's harder with an actual human, but what I imagine cooking with a child is like. Okay, sorry, distracted. 1 3/4 cups of flour. Stay there, please. But yeah, I still have like a ton of pumpkin left. This will use how much? 1.5 cups. So I need something else. I don't know if I should just do pumpkin soup. It's the only thing I can think of that would use a lot of pumpkin. Oh, I didn't even measure that correctly. Can't talk and do things, apparently. But yeah. I'm not sure what else I should do. I know when I made those pizza crusts, it used a bunch of pumpkin. Maybe it... Don't shit! Oh! Clean up time. At least he did it off the counter, I guess.
Thanks for that.
wash my hands. Okay, hopefully he's good for a while now. I don't even remember how many scoops I measured. I think that was the amount. Jesus Christ. What's up, Six? Can you, fuck someone else for a while or something? God, it's so distracting. Yeah, you. This is why I can't, like, film ASMR videos anymore. Because he's either... needs to be... fucking around with things, or... he's making so much noise that I can't film anything. Okay. What's next? Baking soda. Cinnamon cloves. Ingredient space. A very limited space. Thank you. Okay, what am I doing? Teaspoon of baking soda. It's probably gonna end up trying to jump off and falling because you can't fly very well. Cinnamon, nutmeg, cloves, ginger. I don't have anything other than cinnamon. Well, I got some pumpkin spice. And that worked well last time, so I'm gonna do that. We just let him be. Where'd I put my pumpkin spice? Oh, there it is. Okay. Hi. Where's my pets? Oh. See, he comes over, wants pets, and then backs away and doesn't let you actually pet him. So, I don't know. How the fuck does this open? Oh. Very easily, apparently. Need something stabby. Anyways, I think that's my mom. One second. I think we'll wait to a warmer day to go for a walk. It's supposed to warm up. Alrighty. Back to whatever the hell this is. God. Oh yeah, I forget that I can like actually wipe my hands on myself again. So 2 teaspoons of cinnamon and then about 3/4 of a teaspoon of the other spices. That's all. Tasted good though last time, so stick with it. He needs like a perch right here, so he can just be distracting over there. Quarters-ish. Salt. Dry try not to hit the light again. Go. Okay. 3/4 of a teaspoon of salt. That much because I'm not precise enough. Just kind of guess. Yeah, it's about 3/4. Okay, 2 eggs. So I'm going to use egg replacer. I just did this already, yes. Okay. This was, I think, 1 teaspoon per egg. 1 teaspoon plus 2 tablespoons of water. Just kind of pre-mix it a little bit in a little ramekin. I'll find a better setup where I can actually reach my ingredients without hitting the ring light every time I try to open the cupboard. A little whisk. This whisk is way too big, Steve. Please don't bite any cords. Please. Thank you. He's looking. Spoon or spatula, I guess. Ew, is it greasy? God. There. Here's a clean spatula. What's I doing? Whisk. Just whisk the other stuff separately. So I will do that. And here. Okay. So we've got our egg. And then we need sugar, white sugar, brown sugar, pumpkin puree. Ingredient spot again. Wrong thing. 1/2 cup of white sugar, 3/4 cup of brown sugar. I think I have more if I need any more. Where's the cap? Need to refill this. And brown sugar is 3/4 cup. Got my little brown sugar bear thing in here. Move this for a second. Oh god. Don't fall everywhere. So organized? I don't feel organized at all. I feel I feel like I'm in chaos right now. Everything's so messy. And I only have these containers because they were here when I moved in, which is nice. This is actually one of the few things that I really like that the previous owner left. Most of the stuff she left was like super cheap, crappy, or super old stuff that doesn't work. But these Tupperware containers are very nice. And my parents have like the same sort of thing, so I'm used to them. One and a half cups of pumpkin puree. This thingy. We need to preheat the oven. 350. No. I have cups of pumpkin. I'll get there eventually. Need to move all these things. It's so hard to concentrate with things in the way. I don't know how people do it. People can, like, function in a mess. No one else seems to care. Just me. Okay. What else happened in this past week? Hey, a strange fool. I'm making more pumpkin bread right now. I made it last week and it was really good. And I have so much pumpkin puree to use up. So I'm gonna make some more of that. And then I gotta find something else to do with pumpkin. Not all I can think of is soup, but I don't know. Make like a burger patty or something. Veggie patty. I have some beans and lentils and rice. I could do something like that, maybe. I don't know. Gotta keep thinking about it. This weekend kind of came up so quickly because work was so busy. Yesterday I worked, I don't know, 10 and a half hours or something. Just trying to get a whole bunch of stuff done so that I could maybe leave early on Saturday when the weather's nice. And because on Sundays I don't get overtime. So I worked a bunch and then I'm hoping, yeah, I can get off early and try to get all like the packaging stuff done. Oh, that's interesting. For pasta. I'll have to look at some recipes after. I have made a pumpkin or sweet potato pasta once. And it turned out really well. It's a long time ago, though. Can you not bite the cord? I wonder how much pumpkin that would use. Let's see, what else do I need? Half cup of oil, and a quarter cup of milk. Soy milk, and I'll just use canola oil. Yeah. Probably should have done a double batch or something, given a bunch to my roommate.
Oh well, I don't even know if they like it. Three quarters.
Pasta does sound good though. Too bad gnocchi is so annoying to make. So that would be tasty. This all going together, right? I think so. Probably silence my phone. Okay, I'm not going for a walk with my mom today. Maybe I'll take my dog for a walk after this. It's very annoying, I know. It's like fun the first, I don't know, first couple ones that you cut and roll, and then after that it's like, I never want to make gnocchi again. Even if you don't roll them, just cut them into little squares. It's still annoying. I did a gluten-free gnocchi, I don't know, years ago. And it was the most annoying thing in the world. Because the gluten's what holds it all together. And yeah, it was so frustrating to work with. And to get it like the perfect texture where it wouldn't fall apart when it was boiled. Yeah. Uh-huh. It's too bad it's so annoying though, because it's so good. It's one of those things that I find is worth paying for. Gnocchi and sushi, anything that I don't want to make at home. Realized the dog's sleeping over there, another cat over there. Just got animals everywhere today, even though the door is closed, but whatever. All over the place. Okay, so I'm just mixing this in, or folding it in, I guess, just until the flour is kind of absorbed. I think that was all the ingredients, yeah. You can add chocolate chips or whatever. Ooh, could add coconut. That would be good. Maybe on top. Might burn, though. I don't know. It was really good by itself. I'll just leave it as is. But it'd be really good with, like, coconuts and cranberries. Oh, raisins. But I like raisins. I don't have any, though. Okay. I think that's good. It's going to... my pile of crap out of the way. And oil just really quickly came out of the pan really easily last time because I guess it's super oily already. But just in case, extra oil. Really quickly. Animal animals add to the scenery. Yeah, he's more interesting than I am. The problem is that he's not, like, talkative unless you're out of the room, and then he makes very interesting noises. He loves water noises. So maybe he'll do that if I'm running the water. It's not for you. Neighbors are doing something. I still haven't really officially met them yet. They moved in winter, so I've barely seen them. Okay. I think that should be good. And then I'm gonna bake. So 60 to 65 minutes. What? Come on. Come on up. Okay. Well, what do you want to do up here? No. Can't really sit on my shoulder because it would kind of hurt. Where are you going? Hi. Hi. What are you doing? Noises. Okay, no, that was wet. It licked my face. Okay, I mean, that's really hard to like put in the oven. Oh, the oven's not even up to temperature. What do you want to do? Because I can't do two things, or I can't even hold you and do something else. What am I supposed to do? There you go. Okay. I'm gonna put this in the oven anyway. It's almost at temp. I'm gonna check it after 55 minutes. Ugh, it's such a mess over there. I don't want to turn my camera this way, but here we go. You can't see most of the mess, so that's good. My world of dishes. Never ending world. Let me just put this pumpkin away. I don't even know where to start. Actually, I should empty the dishwasher first. Sorry. Back over here. Watch him. Move all this stuff out of the way. Dishwasher flush. I know. Isn't that supposed to mean if you cook, you're not supposed to have to do dishes? Man, our dishwasher at work is quitting. He put in his 2 weeks, and it makes me sad. Even though it's like easier to find a dishwasher usually than anyone else, it still sucks having to like train someone and they have to, like, get used to where everything goes, you know? And this guy was really good. Just kind of sucks, but whatever. Maybe we can find someone who can do dish and prep. All right, Ziggy. You gonna let me unload the dishwasher? Yeah? Mm-hmm. Music background. Is that very exciting? Don't install software. Oh my god. What is happening? Just play music. Okay. Just some music.
It's my computer, Zix.
Please don't fuck it up.
Really? Wow. Do you have usually one dishwasher working at a time, or more than one? Like, we only have one. We used to have two part-time and then switch to one full-time. There you go, the oven's at town. But yeah, that's... I understand it. I started as a dishwasher at a busy place and was quickly overwhelmed. Did not realize just how much work it was, and it was only probably like a 60 seat place, maybe. But I think the problem with where I work is we don't even have like a real, sorry, this is really low, a real dishwasher. Like, it's just a bar dishwasher that it just sanitizes. So you basically have to hand wash everything with soap first and then put it in. Which is a lot of work. And we wanted to get like a pass-through dishwasher. This one's like the kind you have to open, take the tray, load it in, close it, load it out. Tried to have two. Oh, that sucks. I did work at one place that had, on a busy night, there'd be like three dishwashers on, which was crazy how many dishes you could go through, but there's also much better. That was a pass-through, short-cycle dishwasher, whereas one at work's so slow. But yeah, we wanted to get a pass-through, but there's this, like, load-bearing beam right next to where the dishwasher is, and it just could not figure out a way to get it to work. So yeah, we're stuck with that. What's up, Ruby? Oh, I'm almost everywhere. My roommate, who tested positive for COVID, is back to work today, so that's good. Okay. Ah, I need to water my throat. Is bugging me. Thank you. watch him. I don't know what he's doing. He's just sitting there. So heavy. Everything else I have is like Corral, so it's super light.
Stupid heavy plates that don't match.
I don't like it. So confused. Not even clean. Okay. An empty dishwasher. There's one thing done. Decide if I should like hand wash stuff or just throw it in the dishwasher. Probably throw all the plates and bowls in the dishwasher. Dishwasher dishes, I guess. Ugh. One sec. Clear up this other sink. First. Was some sort of meat, I think. That's the bird was squeaking, I guess. Switchblade runner and omelet. Probably not today because I have pumpkin that I need to use up. But I do make a good omelet. I just don't have. I don't even know if I have eggs because I don't eat eggs. Oh, all in on the omelet. Yeah, I know. Probably not good to have a vegan person and ask for omelets. But, I mean, at work I make them. Or I used to make omelets all the time at work, so
I can make omelets. I make them very well.
I just have. Don't have stuff for them. Sorry. I'm not the best person to ask for that. If it was at work, no problem. But tons of eggs. Ugh. Just so cool. I'm just loading up my dishwasher right now. How am I doing? Hey, thanks for following, Switchblade Runner. I am doing well. I'm good. It's a day off, so I'm happy, and I'm just trying to clean up this disaster of a kitchen right now, but I'm just going to turn my camera this way so that you can enjoy the bird while I load the dishwasher. Hey, thanks for following either Crustle or Kay Russell. Yeah, pumpkin bread is in the oven, so it'll be done in 40 minutes. That's it. Hey, thanks for following, House of Kane. Getting closer. But yeah, things are going well. I am enjoying, for the most part, my day, other than animals being crazy and not leaving me alone, but that's okay. Making it hard to get stuff done. Thanks. He is, I don't know, he just won't leave me alone today. He just wants to be part of everything, I think. I don't know, he's a weirdo. Oops, sorry. Just the coffee machine. Many things going on. That bird, yeah. There's also a cat back there, if you can see him being lazy. Surprise, surprise. Do I like ice hockey? Actually, I don't watch any sports, so I'm a terrible Canadian. A lot, like my roommate watches hockey, but definitely not a sports person. Oh, so, yeah, unfortunately.
I know it's the Canadian stereotype, but not all Canadians like hockey. Or care. Where are you from? Germany. Oh, okay. Yeah, if you like hockey, then for sure Canada is a good place to watch it. Oh, you're in Finland. Nice. How are Germany and Finland doing these days? Never played, but you watch. I have never played either because I'm not a good skater. Thanks, House of Kane. What'd you do in there? It's just pecking the wall.
Yeah, weirdo.
Oh. Yeah, I guess so. I haven't really heard much about Germany in a while, other than with reference to like stuff going on in Russia, I guess. Or
Russia and Ukraine.
Just references to like how you guys are responding, but yeah.
Hey, another Finlander? Is that what the word is? Finlandian? Finlander. I don't know. Is that the word?
Oh, really? Because of the Russia stuff, or is it something else? I must say, I hear very little news from Europe. It's mostly American news that we hear, other than Canadian, obviously.
Thanks, Gressel. I hope you have some good food. And you have a good day too.
This is death by 1,000 pecks. I don't know what he's trying to do. He's literally just hitting his beak into the wall. I don't know. What the fuck?
Okay.
Animals are crazy. Of things, I'm gonna wash my hand. Then my kitchen will be semi-presentable. At least then I'll feel like I can actually cook something on this towel. Maybe. I hope.
Alright, then.
Move my giant pile of knives though.
out of his way. Look at some recipes after this and see if there's any other wonderful ideas for pumpkin. I was thinking, like, what do you do with pumpkin puree, or other than pie, obviously? It's also similar to apple puree or I want something savory, not. So definitely look at the pasta idea. I only have all-purpose flour though. I don't have like durum or anything. Like semolina. But I think I've done it with all-purpose before and it was okay. Soup. I don't know, I usually do like a curried. You okay over there? Likes to explore. Yep. Oh God, that's hard to open. This is so skinny. Oh, great. My roommate got one of these things. Exactly what it's made for. Good enough. Can I have this? Can I have that? Thank you. Okay, you're on the floor again. And don't eat my feet. Thank you. Last time? Oh. Yeah. Fuck this. This is boring. Last time he was in here during a stream, he fell asleep in this corner, so I wonder if he's gonna do that again. He's all like preening and looks ready. He had a busy day exploring the counters, exploring the room. Life's hard as a bird. As long as he doesn't try to go back into that vent, I'm good. And as long as I don't step on it. See, at least like cats won't get out of your way, but way too much soap. Savory pancake. Savory pumpkin pancake. I don't know, that'd be weird. Yeah, pretty much, yeah. They're like, I think at least this bird has like the intelligence of like up to a, I don't know, maybe 4-year-old or something like that. I can't remember the age. So they can learn phrases and learn things. But yeah, pretty much like a child. That's what I was saying earlier. It's like trying to cook while having this bird around is like how I imagine it must be to try to cook with children around, or at least one child around. I'm calling here. Attention all the time, a little toddler or something. I feel like people with children probably disagree, but that's how I think of it. That fan's gross looking. Okay, he's back to his corner. And I've only got a couple more things to wash, so okay. I think that's... Oh, there's one more thing. What was in here? Then. Okay, so I got a pile of potatoes, I've got a pile of onions, I've got a few bananas. What can I make? Just screaming pumpkin soup to me. Just the only way I can think of to use like a huge amount of pumpkin. I've got probably 2.5 liters of pumpkin puree. So I need to use a bunch. But I feel like, I think today's like the last cloudy day. So, with nice weather, I never want to eat soup. Ah, don't fall, don't fall. Like, a precarious pile of dishes. Do a pumpkin curry with rice or something? Oh, it wasn't even me. This is from my roommates. So I think, I don't know what they made. I think one was some sort of pork thing. It's from like, I don't know. It's probably been like a week. A little bit less than a week. Because I cleaned the kitchen last week. So... it's just been piling up. It's not, I don't think it's any one thing. But yeah, I know that this dirty dish was from pork tenderloin or something. Yeah, so none of these are my dishes. And yet, I still do, because I can't work in a messy kitchen. Kind of unfortunate, but I mean, also kind of good. Then at least it gets done. Because to be honest, before streaming stuff, it was like messy like this. I'd be like, ah, fuck it, I'm not gonna cook because it's not my mess and I don't want to clean it up. And then I don't make food and then I regret it. So at least this way. Should have some food. Wow. It's been depending on what I make, I should have some food for the week. Either that or just pumpkin bread all week. Yeah. But, I mean, they do other stuff. They do, like, the vacuuming and take out the garbage, and the roommates who live in the basement take care of the cat, all the cats, even my cat, like, feeding and even buy the food and do all the litter. So, I mean, it all works out. It's just, can be irritating sometimes. Especially, like, I just, it's so much easier if people, you know, clean up immediately after themselves, and then it doesn't build up, but. Shouldn't complain. Oh, these knives. Okay, do not drive chop knives on the curb. This one really needs to soak. Then, I'm just gonna look at some recipe. Oh, I should wipe down my counters and then I can get recipes. I know I should have done this yesterday, but so tired after work. I literally came home, had food, and went to sleep. So. It's just a really exhausting week. Yeah, he's chewing on the cupboard. What are you doing? Are you not? Hey. Don't chew on the cupboard. I'd rather. I didn't make the pork thing. It was one of my roommates. I think it was just like a store-bought pork tenderloin that was wrapped in, or not wrapped. It was, he just ripped a piece of the cupboard off. Ziggy! No! Get water for that. But yeah, I think it was just marinated in, I don't know, like maple barbecue or something like that. So I don't know. I didn't eat it. I just saw it. Stop it. The cupboard does not want to be eaten. He's so puffy and angry looking. Yeah, that's right. Get out of the corner. Okay. There he goes. Jesus. He ripped a piece of wood off. Small piece. What a jerk. Yeah, they really liked it. Said it was good. It smelled good, actually. I don't usually like the smell of meat, so. I mean, I'm sure it's just the marinade that I'm smelling, but still good. That's fine. Better than it smelling gross to me. Time to wipe this, and then to wipe down the counters. Okay, 19 minutes till the pumpkin bread's done. Well, maybe not done, but needs to be checked. Smells good. I can't send smells through the screen. Smells really good. This smells like banana bread, I should say. What do I have to make? Oh. Honestly, the curry sounds really good to me right now. With a big pot of rice or something. So I got some lentils and some different beans, I think. Maybe lentils would be good. Lentil, pumpkin, curry. With potatoes? What's a curry with potatoes? The masala? Asama curry? Thai curry? Oh, I wish I had, like, Thai curry paste. That would be really good. Oh, I might. I got some sort of random sauces in my cupboard. Let's see. Let's see what I got before I make any decisions. Or at least like a really deep sink. Should make learn to make curry. There's so many different kinds. Like, I definitely much prefer like Thai curries than Indian curries. I just love like the creamy coconut milk type curries. But yeah, I've never been a huge fan of curry, but I love coconut curries. Japanese curry. Interesting. I don't think I've ever had a Japanese curry. What's in it? Like, what makes it different? I don't think of Japan having curry. I'm sure they do. I just don't think of those two together. Seen like curry on the menu of any sort of Japanese curry cubes. Huh. Okay, so it's just somewhere. It's just something else. Interesting. I guess whatever spices they use are slightly different. The sun's coming out. First time in a few days seeing the sun. It's nice. Get away from my feet. That's what happens when I don't wear socks. He's being annoying. I can search it after. I'm curious. I just think it's weird that I've never seen it on, like, a Japanese menu anywhere. At least I've never noticed it. Maybe it has been. Okay, Skyway. Oh, it's so nice to see the sun. Most of the snow is gone. We've had so much rain that a lot of it's gone. But there's still a few piles. Okay. Where the shade is. And my backyard's like a, I don't know, frozen. A puddle, but also kind of frozen, but also snow, but also dry. I don't know. I've got like five different climates. Abby eats Japanese curry rice.
Okay.
I love
that. Almost done these dishes. Almost done.
Okay. What else am I gonna put all these dishes? I guess just in this sink. Oh, the bread smells so good.
Oh, okay.
Tabby eats. I haven't heard of that. I haven't done much Japanese food, honestly. I've made sushi before. That's about it. I'm trying to think of if I've made any other, like, real Japanese food. So. Oh, I mean, I've made like teriyaki and stir fries and stuff, but. That's true, yes. The internet makes a big difference. You can learn whatever you want. Stuff you didn't ever want to know.
Yeah.
Random things you learn. I always learn very weird things on Reddit. Things I never knew existed. Okay. Just gonna wipe down potatoes and wipe down this counter, and I think I'm good to actually cook something. Finally. Why is it that half the stream is just cleaning? I was better prepared. I do it beforehand, but I mean, I gotta do it anyway. Last week. I ate one of them and still got one in the freezer, which is nice. I made lasagna the next day. So two pieces left, so I think that's probably my dinner for tonight. Unless I have a curry or something. Oh, I got cords everywhere. You'll see the mess on the other two. Pad Thai sauce.
these are both Indian curries. It's a butter chicken and a tandoori. Let's see the ingredients. Where's English? I don't know. I'm just not a huge fan of Indian type curry. Yeah, this one's mango, Indian style pickle. I'm really bad with spicy food, so let me just clean up my bird's mess. Pretty spicy, so I'm just gonna make something up. What time is it? Watch. 12:30. I'll make something. Let's just start with some onions. Tofu. There are lots of tofu. Beans? I think I've got some beans. Lentils. Got some like basic green lentils. I love onion. Every time I make any, just so much onion. Especially soups, it's like half onion. I don't know. Even just the smell of like onions and garlic especially, it's such a nice smell.
even at work when I'm making something, just starting, like, anything that basically starts with, you're sautéing onions, someone will always come and be like, ooh, that smells so good. You eat raw onions? I don't think I could do that. I think that's too strong for me. Unless, say, even if it was a really sweet onion, I don't think I could. I love cooked onions. There's a little scrap of onion skin on the floor that the bird is trying to eat. Well, I just read a thing, I don't know, yesterday? No, a few days ago, where someone was talking about eating raw potatoes, like an apple, which I've never heard of anyone doing, because I thought they were poisonous. So, yeah, I guess there's all kinds of people out there. Okay. I guess as long as it's not that good. Okay, that's good. I can't imagine it being especially tasty. With cooked things. I tend to just like cooked vegetables in general more. Like, I don't like raw peppers, but I like cooked peppers. I don't know. I grew up as a very picky eater. I've become better, but there's still things I don't like. Like, I'm bad with spicy food. I wish I liked spicy food. I can't do it. Baked in the middle. Can we do it like another 7 minutes? Seems like a tiny bit unbaked right in the middle near the bottom. Ah. And it's not that dark on top yet, so it's very close though, I think. Okay, only 7 minutes. Yeah, that's the pumpkin bread.
I know. It
looks way nicer than last time I made it. Last time I made it like in loaf pans, and it wasn't nearly as tall. Like, so it looks much better. You wish you used more fresh veggies. Yeah, I know. I have the problem, like, I'll buy stuff and then won't use it. I won't, like, cook it. And I'll forget about it for a while, and then I'm like, oh, why did I buy this? So I'm trying to buy more frozen veggies so that I don't let stuff get wasted. Because sometimes, I don't know, sometimes work just makes it so I don't feel like cooking at all. But doing these streams helps, because okay, I gotta cook. Gotta make some meals. make the curry and then, or whatever the heck I'm making, and then whatever day I want to eat it, I'll just heat it up and cook some rice. I don't think I'm going to cook the rice today. Rice is so much better fresh. I don't really like it that much left over. Yeah, frozen stuff's good though. Like, certain things are, because they're picked when they're ripest, right, for frozen. So some things are much better to get frozen if it's out of season, or plus it's easier to keep. My problem is my freezer, I don't know. I'm sure it's different over there. You guys probably have smaller, at least what I've seen in, like, what I've seen. You guys tend to have smaller kitchens and fridges and stuff. But for here, our freezer is really small compared to what most people have. It's like, I have the kind of fridge where it's the freezer door, and this one's the fridge, as opposed to being like underneath or on top. And so it's so cramped, it's hard to fit things, and it's just, it's a really old fridge. It's probably from the 80s, 70s or 80s. So, like, stuff in the freezer just tastes like freezer really quickly. So, unless you're using it up right away, it's not that great to have stuff in the freezer. Even bread, after like a week in the freezer, it'll tastes like freezer. No matter what I do. So, eventually I'm gonna get a new fridge. This one's gotta be close to dying. I can't imagine it living that much more. Plus it gets like really, really hot on like the seams, which is not a good thing. Probably not safe. Okay, gotta clear off my stove now so I can actually use it. That's true, I know. But sometimes we go to Costco and get like a big thing of breads, and then I know I'm not gonna. I'd rather have it taste not great, but be usable, than to taste bad. Or to go bad and have to throw it out, I guess. If I'm on top of things, I would dry it out and like make croutons or something, but I'm not usually on top of things. Not if work's busy. Okay. Still pets. Stop eating the cupboard. Ziggy, stop it. Some space. Honestly, I haven't bought bread in a while because the last couple times. Oh my god, he's eating the bread. Ziggy! Stop! Yeah, the last couple times I bought bread, I didn't finish it, so. I'd honestly rather take the time to make bread, because then I know I'll eat it, because it's so big. This is clean. Okay. Where are you going? Put my cloth. bread's just about done. And I'm gonna need to go for a walk and get away from all the animals for a little bit after this. What do we want to start with? I guess I should put some lentils in the pot. Stuff on him. Looks nice and fluffy. I don't know. Looks baked on the bottom. Just gonna let it cool a bit. This is heating up. And lentils. That should be good. What else? Onions, I guess. Garlic. I've got onions. I have like already minced garlic. Makes it easier. It doesn't taste as good, but it works. Stop eating the cupboard! Lentils, yep, they're just basic green lentils. That'll be good. Yeah, that should be enough. It's making me really hungry. It's too hot to eat. I guess? I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. Make some sort of curried lentil thing. But with pumpkin too, so I don't know what it'll really be. It's an experiment. Just see what comes out at the end. Oh, my hair. Sorry. I can feel hair on my back. Okay. Put these out of the sink. Yeah, me neither. The only Indian food I've made is like, what's it called? Chickpea chana masala that I've made before. So yeah, I don't really know. I guess I don't cook that much other cuisines. I've made more Chinese food than any other type of food, I think. I mean, obviously, we tend to learn like French cooking, Italian, more than any other cuisine. We did have, like, when I was in school, we had a global foods course. So we got to do a bunch of different things. We got to make, naan from scratch, like in an actual tandoor oven, tandoori chicken and stuff. That was cool. Oh, Korean. Yeah. Yeah, I tend to like Asian food too. Especially, I think, because I don't eat meat, there's often more options, and I love tofu, and there's usually tofu in Asian things. I know like Vietnamese food tends to have a lot of fish sauce, so it's not normally vegan, but I do love Asian food. I wonder if I should throw some tofu in here too. Maybe I will. I'm gonna dice up a brick of tofu. Oh, I have wrinkly peppers. I'm gonna use those. Stop eating the cupboard. I forgot my roommate stuck these in my fridge. They're all wrinkly, but should be okay. No fish sauce. Yeah, or oyster. That's good. Haven't had that much Korean food. I think they tend to have a lot more meat than the other Asian stuff, but I've had like bibimbap. That's good. But yeah, I don't like growing up, most of my friends were Chinese, so I got to have like a lot of try real Chinese food. But I didn't really get to, I don't think I really tried any other Asian foods from an actual person of that descent, you know? I don't think. Back to here. This thing's gonna end up falling. There we go. Not stirring that guy down. Good. I dropped an onion. My dogs will clean it up later. Even though they're probably not supposed to eat onion. Still do. To be fair, one of my dogs apparently ate a whole bunch of chocolate a few days ago. Somehow got into my roommate's box of chocolate. And, ate it. So, but she's been fine. So, yeah. I think it was white chocolate, though. So, this will be vegan. Yeah, not just vegetarian. I don't use eggs. Like, my roommates do. They eat everything, but if I'm making food, I'll make it vegan, usually. Oh, this knife needs to be sharpened. I'm glad you're fine with it. God, this knife. These wrinkly skin, they're not cutting through very well. I'm just gonna do my tofu. Just gonna drain the water out. This might not all fit in this pan. I'm gonna make it fit. Maybe I'll just do half then. I'm just gonna do like a dice. decide if I should cut the pepper smaller. Maybe I will. I don't have big chunks of peppers. Oh yeah, God, I have. Honestly, I lived like on the east coast of Canada for a couple of years when I was going to university. And there's such like a big vegan scene there, and everyone there was super cool. And then moved back here. It was like, that was around the time when I first gotten into veganism. And I moved back here and God, people are so, like, so picky about it. And as someone working in a restaurant, like, God, I hate vegans. Just lots of, I mean, not all of them, but so many of them are so over the top about things. It just makes everyone look bad, I feel like. Yeah, like, yeah, it's frustrating. You have those, like, we have people complaining that our food, that something that we said is vegan, because, I mean, I'm vegan, and I made the food, and it's like, I know it's vegan. I had someone complain, it's not vegan because it's made on the same flat top as other meat products. Like, yeah, but the product itself still is vegan. It hasn't even, like, touched the same spot on the flat top. It's, I don't know. And they, like, made social media posts about it. God. I also once was in this vegan group, like, on Facebook. And let me just turn this. There was a. I posted a picture. It was like a savory macaron. Because someone had asked, is there any way to use macarons like in a savory way? And I found these like squid ink macarons with smoked salmon or something. And I was like, oh. Could do something like this, but vegan, you know? And the post got taken down for being offensive because it showed dead animal. Like, it was just a suggestion. I'm not saying make that. I'm not saying that that's okay, even. I'm just saying it's an option. Could do something like that. But it offended people. It was ridiculous. Stop eating the cupboard, fucker.
Ziggy, stop it.
Can you get out of here, please?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna start throwing these peppers in.
Yes, some people are overly sensitive, for sure. Just makes me amazed, like, why are these people on the internet, and do you really expect to never see dead animal or meat anywhere in your life? Like, it's kind of ridiculous. We also hired a dishwasher once at my work, and she was vegan, which is fine. We've had a lot of vegan people work for us. But she was just doing dishes and she couldn't do it because of, she had to wash some pans that chicken had been cooked in and she couldn't do it. Why did I grab that? That was the squishies. Yeah. Yeah, she quit because she didn't want to have to touch anything that meat was on. Which is really disappointing because we told her that, like, before she was hired, like, hey, we have a lot of meat on our menu and there's lots of things you're gonna have to be around. She's like, I think it's okay. Yeah, I guess they do live in a bubble. It's just ridiculous. I mean, People can do what they want, but when you expect other people to follow your beliefs, it makes no sense. Or at least be really nice about it, and it would go a long way. Last little bit of peppers going in. I'm glad I finally get to use these up. Yeah, it's kind of like all in the attitude. If people are nice about it, no one's gonna mind like doing something extra or whatever. Well, not no one, but most people won't mind. I guess so. I don't know. It's gonna turn into some sort of curry eventually. I think. That's the plan. I don't even have room for all the pumpkin. There's so much pumpkin I have left from last week. It was just one of my pumpkins I cooked off. I still have another one. I didn't cook it off, so definitely use up this. And I think I'm gonna put some coconut milk, some curry spice. Who knows how this will turn out, but I don't know, it should be tasty, even if it's not a real curry or whatever. It should be good. I don't have like all the right spices for a really good curry, I'm sure. I'm gonna try my best. What do I got? I've got chili. Cumin. I better have curry powder after all this. Oh, yeah, got a whole thing of curry powder. Cumin is new. It's starting to smell like I should be making Mexican food. Yes, it's going to be curry enough. I hope so. I don't really have a lot of spices. What else do I get? Got turmeric. Oh, that'll make it a nice yellow color. Yeah. Got chili powder. Yeah, it's probably going to make it too Mexican. I'll see. I also got salted pepper, lots of garlic. I don't have ginger. That would be good. What you doing? Going after my feet or something. I don't know. Ziggy, stop it. Actually, still a little bit more. But I ran out of water. Yeah, true. Tofu, it can be
whatever. It's great for flavor. I even like it just like plain fried salt and pepper. I don't know. I didn't use to though. Let's do some garlic. Get a spoon or something.
Ziggy. Stop.
He's all like fluffed up, walking backwards. Lots of garlic. Open this can. These are cooked, so. I don't know, I'm just guessing on everything. So that's the curry. Get a little bit of pepper. The turmeric, which I really like the flavor of, so I'm gonna put a bunch. It's probably gonna stain my spatula. But. Okay, and then I'm gonna add the coconut milk. It looks like curry, if nothing else. I can always add some of that tandoori or butter chicken sauce, or if it's not curry enough. That's strain them. Ooh, that's going to be hot in there. Before. Let them kind of absorb some of the flavor. Cilantro, sorry.
Ziggy.
Oh, I didn't put the funk in it. My most important ingredient. The thing I'm trying to use up. No. Stupid. Okay. Throw some of this in here. piece missing now from the cover. Okay. Trying to. This made a lot of food. These away. I feel like I could use more coconutiness. Just doesn't look creamy enough. So much food. Why did I make so much? I always do this. Have to make it taste good so that you can eat it all. Not more salt. I have this coconut. I don't know. One second, let me grab it. Creamed coconut stuff. I add some of this in. It's like, I've never used this before. It's just like solid condensed coconut. Just mix it with water and it makes coconut milk apparently, which I've never heard of before. I tried it a little while ago. This used to work. If I could break it. If I could get out. If I can mix that in. Stop. Spray you with water. Okay. Mix the salt in. That more like creaminess.
Ooh, maybe I could make coconut rice to go with it.
And then it might be more creamy. I don't know, it just has a kind of boring flavor. Maybe I should mix some of this other stuff in. So, this is water, ginger, tamarind, spices. This one's water, sugar, tomato, spices, tamarind. Hey, where's my shoe? See if that makes any kind of difference. It smells different now. Actually tastes way better. Has more flavor. Tastes like curry. Can't taste the pumpkin, but it thickened it up, which is nice. Okay. I'm gonna leave it like that.
Ziggy, stop.
Just gonna put this on a tray.
I'm just dropping things, apparently.
I was just gonna wash these dishes and then put everything away. I'm doing pretty well.
Other than this bird driving me insane. Stop. Trying to eat my cupboard. If I could reach the camera there, I'll show you I would. Got multiple pieces of my poor innocent cupboard. Need to find him something else to destroy while I'm distracted. He destroyed an old PlayStation controller. But it was, like, super old. It was fine. But definitely destroyed it more than I thought he possibly could. Soak this a little bit while I clean up the other stuff. Alright, so I gotta put away this tofu, and I still have to put all the spices away. God, he's like standing right in the way. Like a bad bird. And I should open that. Okay. Spices. 5 million spices. I used to have them all nice and alphabetical, but it's been a little while since this was organized. That's the only thing that needs to go in there, I think. We'll put this away. And I'm just gonna put away this tofu. It's just gonna go in the fridge. And yeah. This way, this is just gonna be compost. They're very sad. And then onion scraps I usually just use for stock. So a little bag in the freezer. Yeah. Other bags full, so. I just use these to make veg stock once in a while. Big enough container. Oh, I do. Maybe. There for a second. Oh, no. He is like right under my feet, so I'm trying not to step on him. I know what I'm eating for the next several days. That is. Ready.
Every animal has to sit or stand exactly where I want to be. For whatever reason.
It's not the bird, it's the cat.
It's not the cat, it's the dogs.
You can see the spatula stained from the
turmeric. Sun is still peeking out. It's really nice. I wonder what the temperature is.
My watch doesn't say.
Is there a button for it? There used to be. God, I never use this watch. Weather. See if it connects. I never was able to, I can't click at my hand. Never mind. I was never able to connect in for whatever reason. It just does not work well, the Fitbit with Samsung phones, I find. It's definitely made for an iPhone. Which I don't have. Cutting board still. Okay. Try to get all the yellow stain out of here. Rinse it. place to dry things. Dry some things in the sink, I guess. Grab the sink out quickly. Much better. At least the kitchen is cleaner than it was before I started. I can enjoy it being clean for the rest of the day and not have to cook anything. We'll see. My roommates will probably cook something. Shit. Alright. Cutting board is going away. Dry it off. Being really gross. Maybe I'll just sweep quickly because it's disgusting. Oh, my feet have. My shoes, I should say, have bird. Bird droppings on them. That's lovely. I'm just gonna sweep the floor. If I have a broom. Loud. I guess he doesn't like the broom. Thanks.
like scared of it, but he's just interested in it. Hey, sorry, this floor is disgusting. It's a problem with having three cats and two dogs and a million birds. Plus people. Plus it's muddy outside and wet. No one else ever sleeps. Maybe I'll still go for a walk today. Clouded back up. We'll see. Anyway, thank you for hanging out. And yeah, enjoy the rest of your Monday. The rest of your week. Ziggy, stop. And I'll be back on Friday for a gaming stream. Or should be back next Monday. Another cooking stream. And hopefully I can make something a little bit more exciting. Kind of want to do vegan pepperoni or something, since I had a request for that. And I need to see what ingredients I need, but I think I have most of it, so I'd like to try that next time. Anyway, have a great week, and a great night. Bye.